So, I'm listening to Eye of Cat audiobook, narrated by the author, Roger Zelazny. Probably my favorite writer. There was a time when I might have said Robert E. Howard, but that was a while ago. And Roger Zelazny, for quite a while now, has been my favorite author. It's a little ironic. He died in 1995 from cancer, colon cancer. And he did narrate some of his books, but only recently have I found a couple of the narrations that I didn't know existed, because they were books that were not in a series. His most famous series is called the Amber series, or the Chronicles of Amber, and it's a series of 10 novels. And I knew that he had narrated 9 out of the 10 before he passed, but as it turns out, there's a couple of other things that he narrated. I'm listening to one of them called Eye of Cat. I have college football on the TV, and my favorite band on the stereo way in the background, Wussy. And I'm sitting in a rocking chair. I usually have a setup like this, which is a wall of sound. I have 3 layers of sound. When they're playing basketball in that obnoxious court that the neighbors built right below my office window. And I guess, as long as I'm making a video, what the hell, the big subject is the election. And if I can get across any thought, here's the one thought I would like to get across. Ranked choice voting. If you don't know what it is, here's how it works. You can pick your first choice for president, and then you pick your second choice for president. And if your first choice has no chance of winning, the vote then goes to your second choice. That's how it works. So a lot of the people could have gone ahead, you know, voted for Jill Stein or whatever. And there's a good chance a lot of them would have had Hillary as their second choice. Or third choice. I don't know exactly how it works because it's fairly new. It was just adopted by the state of Maine. And it's a much better way to vote. You know, never mind getting rid of the Electoral College or anything like that. If we had a national level of ranked choice voting, I think the elections would be a lot more fair. Because it's really a silly old notion to expect people to only like one candidate when there's tons of people, you know, all the way down the list in all sorts of obscure parties who will run. And if you allow them to rank their choices, and with the understanding that if first choice has no chance of winning, goes to the second choice, and it ensures that the candidates you like have a better chance. You can vote for who you like, and if you like more than one, you can vote for them too. You know, it seems a no-brainer. So here we are, the reign of President Trump. Okay, I think it's only fair that we give the man a chance. A lot of people don't want to, based on his past. But you gotta clear the slate. You know, he's in a totally different position now than he's ever been before in his life. Clean slate. Let's see what he does. We can be dubious, you know, we can be doubtful. Well, let's at least sit on our hands, hold our tongues, and give him a chance. And then, if it is what we fear it might be, that's the time to say something or protest. That's what I think. Alright, it's my vlog.